Shannon, Sarah, Two Hot Babes Who Rock. Everything about them rocks. They got excellent jobs at a huge record company. Rockin'. Killer apartments and fucking CDs up the butt. Rockin', right? Basically, they got the kind of lives I'd give my left nut to have. They really go for what they want, you know. I admire that in a woman. I also admire a woman who knows when to be soft and gentle. Like a warm peanut butter sandwich. But she should also rock. You know, like, check this out. You know what I love? Taking bubble baths with women. Naked. So anyways, they got these gigs which to you and me look like sunshine and buttercups. But what can reality really fucking suck? They gotta do shit like listen to music they hate and kiss a corporation full of big, fat, hairy, don't know dick about music asses. They say it rapes their souls.
What soul?
Ugly word to your mother.
You're late. You know, Jen, I'm really nervous about this meeting, and it doesn't help to... Would you come on already?
Did I tell you I found a spider in my panties last night?
Again?
Yeah, but this time I was still wearing them.
Oh, Jesus. I don't know where they're coming from.
It's just good. No.
Yeah, it would be really cool if we had Reuben Kincaid with us right now.
You don't think that I can manage our band as well as Reuben Kincaid? He doesn't even really exist.
Sarah?
Yeah?
I think I love you, but what am I so afraid of?
Yeah, I'll get back to you. I'm a girl player. All right? So, you girls are huge where?
That's women, and we're huge in New Guinea.
What'd you call me?
Crotch is about the will to rock. The endless, undying, throbbing need to rock 25 hours a day.
That's who we are. You are Crotch. We are Crotch. The whole world is one big, stinking Crotch.
Look, honey, I know you girls can rock. I discovered the Go-Go's when they were little fat girls who could just barely keep their pudgy hands together to keep a beat. You got me, babe?
Yeah, I got you. I got you right here, you fudge-nosed pus weasel. It's about time you learned something about respect, Pinto.
Bean.
Because we are not your little fat girls, and we most certainly do not have to put up with your crap. And if you ever compare us to the Go-Go's again, I'm gonna pull your tired little scrotum so far up over your balding head that you're gonna need a ladder to scratch your balls.
That's it. Talk dirty to me.
I can't believe you did that again, Sarah.
Fine. You go to the meetings and I'll sit around here dressed like Madonna with my thumb up my butt.
Wasn't there a picture like that in her book?
Yeah, except she had her thumb stuck up somebody else's butt.
Now, why the thumb? You think if you really wanted to get in there, you'd go with a finger, like
just... Oh, shut up!
If you spent as much time practicing as you do with your own thumbs up each other's butts, we'd be bigger than Zeppelin by now.
Sorry, Ma.
I'll give her big.
You always talk about big, Mr. Big Stuff. I'll give you big. I'll show you so much big, you don't know what big is.
band in America whose album, Birth, has critics and fans like screaming like babies. They've just released a second album. It's called Afterbirth. Gang, why the title?
There's nothing more mysterious than Afterbirth. Nobody knows where it comes from, why it exists, or even what it means. But the fact remains, Afterbirth is a part of all of us. It's there from the very beginning. I mean, it's all over. You're covered in it, and there's nothing you can do about it.
Nothing, Dirk. In fact, Dirk, for every door this album unlocks, it locks 1,000 more. Then, it unlocks those, but relocks the ones it originally unlocked.
Oh, that's fascinating. Joe, do you have anything to add?
Yeah, it's simple, Dirk, you know. Afterbirth is, you know, it's like big chunks of mental vomit from my brain. Spewed blood out all over America. Just about all.
He's our poet.
Yeah. Okay, take us back to Central.
We're gonna be huge. So very huge.
1, 2, 3, 4!
Got a wedgie, but you don't got one. You got
one. That's very cool, Pete.